Victoria is reducing stamp duty on new developments today to encourage denser developments. Do you think that this is a good idea?
Well, I find it an extraordinary announcement in the light of other announcements that were made this weekend. If the state government really wanted to see new supply of housing, they would fast-track zoning and planning approvals. I know that there are around 18,000 houses that have been held up for nearly a decade in places like Balan in Western Victoria, Western Melbourne, I should say. And at the same time, there is already a stamp duty discount available to new home buyers. I'm not entirely sure what this is going to achieve. The federal coalition announced over the weekend an additional $5 billion over the next 5 years to unlock supply of new housing developments by creating enabling infrastructure. That seems to be where the roadblock is. That's what the Property Council have told us. That's what the Master Builders have told us and the Urban Infrastructure Institute have told us. We've identified thousands of homes that could be developed immediately if it weren't for that enabling infrastructure that's holding things up. That's what a coalition government will deliver.
Yeah, but just on stamp duty, the Business Council of Australia wants to move away from stamp duty in favour of a land tax in a plan that's been released today. Would you support the states in this move if they did embark on ambitious stamp duty reform?
Well, in Victoria, we've seen both stamp duty and land tax go through the roof because Victoria is essentially bust. If you've got a broke state, all that's going to happen is they'll use this as a grab bag opportunity to increase taxes further. That's not going to help the housing supply in Victoria. This is simply a demand-driven measure. We want to see housing supply open up. That is in the hands of state governments, but they've failed to do their bit. And federal Labor have failed to assist them in that. They've essentially thrown money at the states, but not delivered that extra supply. That's what a coalition government will do, is go directly to the heart of the problem, create and unlock that bottleneck of supply by creating enabling infrastructure on those greenfields and brownfields development sites that have already been identified.
Former New South Wales Premier Dominic Perrottet, he tried to take it to the last New South Wales election where he would phase out stamp duty to bring in land tax. Of course, he didn't get in. Do you think that's a big reason as to why, federally at least, we're not talking about this transition away from stamp duty because, you know, parties are worried that it is politically unpopular?
Well, it is very much the purview of state governments, and state governments have failed to do that. Unfortunately, it seems to be that state governments that have failed to unlock supply. This stamp duty is a demand-driven issue. We want to make sure that there is more supply. That's the only way you're going to sustainably bring down the price of houses right across the country. State governments have failed to unlock that supply through both planning and zoning reforms and through providing the enabling infrastructure. Now, a coalition federal government will step in and go to where the bottlenecks are by enabling that, by creating that enabling infrastructure that will allow the developments to continue. We've identified hundreds of sites, thousands of sites that would deliver around 500,000 new homes that would not have been built before, that will have been stalled potentially for decades. That's what a coalition government, a federal coalition government, will do, actually deliver on the promise of new supply of land.
OK, Jane Hume, enjoy that royal visit today. Thank you.